Stephen Poloz is sounding the alarm bells on fallout from global trade tensions. As NAFTA talks drag on with no end in sight, the Bank of Canada governor says there are no do-overs for corporate decision makers.
Companies postponing or delaying important decisions. While we're making decisions that are different, investing in the United States or whatever, just to hedge against the risks that present. And unfortunately, these are decisions that only come up once every few years. There are highly strategic decisions for a company. So if we lose an investment because of that, well, we're not going to get that investment back just because NAFTA gets cleared up.
Murray, welcome to the close. Let's now get caught up on the markets. We are seeing a little bit of a risk on day to day. Take a quick look here at the North American equity markets for those U.S. markets moving higher. TSX relatively unchanged on the day. When we look at those U.S. markets, they certainly are adding to Friday's gains that followed on the strong jobs report. Of course, the ongoing trade negotiations are very much front and center with backlash from G7 finance meetings over the weekend. And of course, U.S.-China trade talks ended in an impasse. Nonetheless, those U.S. markets are charging higher, again, on the back of that strong U.S. jobs report. There are a few corporate stories to watch as well. Take a look at the shares of Facebook right now. A little bit of negative news surrounding Facebook on data sharing concerns once again. So when you see a stock down in an up day, you are certainly seeing investors sell the stock on these concerns. And as well, tech does continue to be a real theme amongst investors these days. Tech not only leading the markets higher, but certainly also leading global economies higher. Take a look at what's going on with Apple and Microsoft today. Apple, of course, kicks off their Worldwide Developers Conference for the week, sending those shares up by about 1%. And Microsoft, interestingly, is getting quite a bit of note from investors, surpassing $100 for the first time, up by 0.60%. And also, of course, making an acquisition, which we'll get to in just one moment. And as I say that, let's take a look at the headlines right now.
Started with the developer tools for the Altair, and now we're all in on open.